It's time now for the next After the Fact mystery. Tonight, The Restless Dead.
Oh, this house is dreadful. Damp and musty and dark.
Well, it's supposed to be dark. We're here to hunt ghosts, remember? And on Halloween Eve, too. What better time?
Dumb idea.
Except that we get paid whether we find one or not. You can't beat that for a deal.
The Narramores said they were desperate to resolve the matter one way or another before they move out. Are you nervous about this?
Are you kidding? It's no more dark and musty than the old Odeon Theater. And in there, your feet stuck to the floor. I remember I was in there one night with...
Never mind. Just stop cracking your knuckles, please. Or are you nervous?
Well, it's midnight. When is Miss Lucinda going to put in her appearance?
Any second now, supposedly. And it's Mrs. Lucinda Ashton. She drowned after the wedding. Remember the picture the Narramores gave us? Lucinda in her wedding dress, and that big diamond on her finger.
How'd she manage to drown on her wedding night, anyway? Now, she must have gone sailing with that boyfriend of yours, the one with the runaway boom.
Very funny. Look, I got us into that situation, and I got us out of it, okay? I was just trying to be helpful. How was I supposed to know the guy was homicidal? Anyway, Lucinda died 23 years ago.
And she's supposed to walk this house every night at midnight. She's late. 2 minutes late. Typical...
Don't say it. It was only a few weeks ago that the appearances started. And before that, it was just a matter of people getting eerie feelings in the house. And I can't say I blame them. Well, I don't see anything. Might as well call it a night. It's cold in here.
Well, that wouldn't be very sporting. Maybe Lucinda couldn't keep track of the time when she was alive. What makes you think she'd be any better at it now that she's dead? Dana?
Oh, Mark, look! At the top of the stairs!
What do you make of that?
It's Lucinda. There's no doubt about that. Just as she is in the pictures from her wedding. Look at those clouds floating around her.
She's not moving.
Yes, she is. See that? Ugh, creepy. Really creepy, the way she jerks her head and arms back and forth. It's so unnatural. She's so...
Stiff?
No, don't say that. Just look at her floating there.
Let her float there. I guess we've seen enough. I probably should be toddling along now, unless you want to invite her down for tea.
Not on your life. Oh, wait a minute. She doesn't have to come down. I'm going up. In fact, I'm going to walk right through that little witch.
You are?
I sure am. She's nothing but a mirage. Look at her hands.
I always said you ought to be in pictures, but this isn't exactly what I had in mind. You really don't look your best with Lucinda projected all over you.
Maybe not. But it's going to feel great spreading this story all over town. The Narramores are going to wish they'd never dreamed up this little Halloween horror.
Now let me get this straight. There really was a Lucinda Ashton.
Yeah. And she really did drown on her wedding night. In her wedding dress at that. During the reception. A pier collapsed.
Well, that's the stuff of a good ghost story.
Sure. And it's been common knowledge around here all along. So when the Narramores bought the house 6 years ago, they decided to make some money off of it. And they started talking about how strange things were happening in the house. Then set up this little slideshow to convince a few people. Including us. They figured if they could get a couple of neutral observers to check it out and announce that they had seen a genuine ghost in the house, they could play it up and work the book and the movie angle.
After making a big deal about turning down the first few offers, of course. Bowing finally to popular demand for the good of science and all.
Great job with the overhead projector, too. They make slides from a couple of Lucinda's wedding pictures, shoot a little video with dry ice around them for effect, and bingo, they've got this jerky ghost with ectoplasm or something floating around her.
Slipped up on one detail, though. Clever of you to catch it.
Shouldn't have put the slides in backwards. Got the wedding ring on the wrong hand.
Slipped past me.
You're cracking your knuckles again, Mark.
Be sure to listen for the next After the Fact mystery.